In 2035, the crew of the Ares 3 mission to Mars is exploring on Martian Solar Day 18 of their 31-sol expedition. A severe dust storm threatens to topple their Mars ascent vehicle. The mission is scrubbed, but as the crew evacuates, astronaut Mark Watney is struck by debris and lost in the storm. The telemetry from his suit's biomonitor is damaged, and Watney is wrongly presumed dead. With the MAV on the verge of toppling, the surviving crew takes off for their orbiting vessel, the Hermes. Watney awakens after the storm, injured and with a low oxygen warning. He returns to the crew's surface habitat and treats his wound via self-surgery. As Watney recovers, he begins a video diary. Lacking communication with Earth, his only chance of rescue is via the next Mars mission, 4 years later, where the Ares 4 will be landing approximately 3,200 kilometers or 2,000 miles away from his current position. Watney's immediate concern is food. Being the mission's botanist, he improvises a garden inside the habitat, using Martian soil fertilized with the crew's bio-waste, and manufactures water from leftover rocket fuel. He then plants the crew's unused potatoes. He also begins modifying the rover for the distance trek to the Ares 4 landing site. On Earth, NASA's satellite planner Mindy Park, reviewing aerial habitat images, notices moved equipment and realizes Watney is still alive. NASA director Teddy Sanders publicly releases the news, though the Ares 3 crew, still en route back to Earth, are not told so that they remained focused on their mission. Sanders overrules Hermes flight director Mitch Henderson, who believes the crew should know. Watney takes the rover to retrieve the nearby Pathfinder probe, which fell silent in 1997. Using Pathfinder's camera and motor, he establishes rudimentary two-way communication with Earth, first using handwritten signs, and then sending and receiving ASCII in hexadecimal. NASA transmits a software patch to link the rover with Pathfinder and communicate via text. Watney is angry that the Hermes crew is unaware that he is alive, though he does not blame them for leaving him behind. Sanders finally allows Henderson to inform them. Mars mission director Vincent Kapoor and the Jet Propulsion Laboratory team prepare an IRIS space probe to deliver enough food for Watney to survive until Ares 4's arrival. Meanwhile, the habitat's airlock malfunctions, killing the potato plants and sterilizing the soil. Believing it to be a low risk, Sanders orders the routine pre-flight safety inspections be bypassed to expedite the probe's launch. The rocket explodes soon after liftoff. Watney now believes his death on Mars is inevitable. The China National Space Administration has been developing a classified booster rocket. Feeling camaraderie with NASA's scientists, they sought a way to work around official barriers and offer to repeat the IRIS mission. As Watney's situation grows riskier as time passes, astrodynamicist Rich Purnell devises an alternative plan. Have the booster rocket rendezvous and resupply the Hermes, which will then use Earth's gravity to slingshot back to Mars, 2 years earlier than Ares 4. Sanders rejects the idea, considering it too risky for the Hermes crew. Henderson secretly sends Purnell's plan to the crew. They unanimously vote to implement it, disabling NASA's remote controls and making the course change. Powerless to stop them, NASA concedes the issue. Watney begins the long journey to where the MAV for Ares 4 has been pre-positioned. The MAV needs to be lightened to intercept with Hermes on its new course. Watney removes many components and replaces the nose cone with canvas. After takeoff, the MAV fails to reach the required speed. Commander Lewis maneuvers the Hermes to decelerate by using the spacecraft's RCS system. She also orders a directional explosive decompression of the internal atmosphere to better align the ship. In a manned maneuvering unit, Lewis is unable to reach Watney when the tether falls short. Watney pierces his pressure suit, using the escaping air to propel himself to Lewis. He and the crew are reunited after Mark's 560 sols alone on Mars. After returning to Earth, Watney becomes a survival instructor for astronaut candidates. 5 years later, as the Ares 5 is about to launch, those involved in Watney's rescue are seen in their current lives.